Namaste. I'm going to work on our strength and mobility. So just take a moment, your hands at your heart, feet under your hips, soften or close your eyes, relax your shoulders, and just take a moment just to notice how you feel right this moment, with no judgment, no criticism, no expectations either. Just simple curiosity. So noticing how you feel physically. If there's any areas of tension, any aches or pains. Noticing how you feel energetically. Bear in mind that some days are full of energy and other days not quite so. And noticing how you feel emotionally. Again, our emotions are up and down. You know, we're not robots, we're emotional, spiritual beings. There's one word to describe how you feel right now. Whatever word pops into your mind is perfect. Take a nice deep breath in. And let it go. Open your eyes, release your hands, shift your weight onto one foot. And circle out the other foot. You need to use the wall also to balance. Go around the head and circle around the other way. Spread out the toes, press into the ball of the foot, and imagine circling that heel. So loosening up into your heels, into your toes, into your ankles, and go around the other way. So you're breathing nice and deeply, in and out through the nose. That knee around, loosening up into your hip joints. You can make the circle as big or as small as you like. 3, 2, and 1. And just take a moment just to simply notice how that side feels compared to the other side. Sometimes you may notice a big difference, other times it may be just a subtle difference, but you should notice that your right leg feels, or the leg that you've just done, it feels different to the other side. So we'll even it up, so circle out your other foot. Again, sometimes you find you can balance fine on one side, not the other. Go around the other way. Yeah, press into the ball of the foot and circle the heel around. And around the other way. Getting fluid into all your joints. Then circle the knee around into your hip joints. 3, 2, and 1. Let's take the feet a little bit wider than hip width, hands on your waist. Inhale, come forward about halfway. Exhale as you come up, almost imagine leaning back slightly, only as far as feels right for you. This also helps to stimulate our liver. Exhale forward, inhale back. Keep your belly firm, but your shoulders relaxed. And go slower if you need to. You can make the circle smaller if you need to. One more this direction. And then change direction, go around the other way. We're not coming too far forward today. Just literally coming about halfway, as if we're in a flat back position. Squeeze your butt slightly as you lean back a little bit. If it doesn't feel good to lean back, then don't do it. One more here. And come back up to standing. And just doing a circle with one arm. The rest of the body nice and relaxed, loosening up into the shoulders, go back the other way. And change to the other side. Keep the rest of the body relaxed. You might notice one side feels tighter than the other. Change direction. Release, and imagine you've got a pencil on the tip of your nose, a bit of paper in front of you, and draw draw a circle. Imagine you're drawing a circle on your bit of paper. And notice how all the movements are circular. The body loves circular movements. And changing direction, going around the other way. Chin comes to the chest this time. Float the head back up. Awesome. Bring your thumbs and index fingers together. As you breathe in, you're going to lift the left knee up and you're going to bring the arms out to the side. As you breathe out, you're going to bring the right knee up and bring the arms straight up. So we left knee, arms out to the side, right knee, arms up. We breathe in and out. In and out through the nose. So it's a dynamic move designed to raise your energy, raise your heart rate. And as you exhale, pull your belly button in towards the spine. Remember, if we want energy, we have to move. If we want more energy, we need to put more effort in. Your feet nice and wide. Start to feel the stretch in the hips and inner thighs. Shoulders relaxed, hands on the hips. We're going to come into warrior two. So you're going to turn your right foot out 90 degrees, spread out the toes, then turn the left heel out. So both toes are kind of pointing in the same direction. Just make sure that top hip hasn't lifted. So level your hips, press firmly into both feet as you bend your right knee. And you want to make sure that knee doesn't go over the ankle. So if it's like that, you need to wiggle your toes forward. Press that knee out by engaging your inner thigh and squeezing your butt and draw your shoulders so your shoulders are in line with your hips. Now really engage your legs. So this is to work your legs as well as stretch around your hips and groin. You're gonna reach the arms out as if you're reaching to opposite walls. Look towards the middle finger of your front hand. As you breathe in, imagine breathing from your tailbone to the crown of your head. As you breathe out, soften your shoulders and relax your shoulders. Inhale, press into both feet as if you're trying to stretch the mat apart. As you breathe out, bend a little bit deeper, sinking those hips down towards the floor. Grip slightly with your toes. Press into all four corners of both feet. So you'll feel your legs working. Pull up the thigh muscles and the back leg. Make sure this back leg is totally straight. Keep reaching through the fingertips. Two more breaths. And inhale, press into both feet as if you're trying to rip the mat. As you breathe out, sink the hips a little bit deeper. Keep squeezing your glutes. Once more, breathe in. Breathe out. And breathe in, straighten both legs. Bring your back hand onto your back thigh. Turn your front hand palm up. Inhale, stretch up. And imagine sliding your back hand down your back leg. You can either look up, if that doesn't feel right on your neck, look down towards your back foot. Keep stretching up. Feel the stretch on this side of the body. Tighten up the thighs and the kneecaps, both legs. Take another breath. Breathe in again. I'm going to come back to warrior two. So as you breathe out, lift up. Come back into your warrior two. Rest your elbow very gently so there's no weight there. We're not hanging out here. There's no weight here. And reach your left arm straight up to the sky, but relax your shoulders. Firm up your belly. So you should be able to lift the underneath arm away. So press into both feet, reaching through the fingertips. Inhale, press into both feet. So you're trying to stretch the mat apart. Exhale, try and sink a little bit deeper. Imagine squeezing your thigh muscles around your thigh bones. reach up, imagine you're pressing back behind you, but don't tense your shoulders. Breathe in again. And out, see if you can sink a little bit deeper. Then power up. Inhale, lift up, come up. Turn both feet forward. Relax your hands, hands onto your hips. Just take a breath here, a little mini rest. Bring your heels in, bend both knees, press both knees out, lightly rest, elbow to the thigh, lift the other arm up, inhale, lift up, exhale over the other side. Inhale up, engage your core, exhale across. Keep going, so you want to imagine that your lower body stays totally still. So keep squeezing your glutes. Imagine pressing your knees out over your toes. One more. Now lift up, reach to the corners of the room. Relax your arms, turn your feet back to the front. Just take another little mini rest. Out through the mouth if you want to. Sometimes it's good to let a breath go through your mouth. Then we do all on the other side. So turn your left foot out 90 degrees. Spread out your toes. Press into all four corners of your feet. Turn your right heel away. Level out your hips so you're not doing a Beyonce hip. Press into both feet as you bend that front knee. Again, check that that knee doesn't go over your ankle and check that the knee isn't dropping in, isn't falling in. So press it out, squeeze your bum. So you should feel the stretch around the groin and you should feel your legs working. Pull up the thigh muscles of that back leg. Draw your shoulders in line with your hips and reach through the fingertips. Towards the middle finger of your front hand. Inhale, stretch in both directions. Exhale, soften your shoulders so you're not tensing your shoulders around your ears. And as you breathe in, imagine you're trying to split the mat apart. So you're pressing the feet in opposite directions. And as you breathe out, sink your hips down and really tighten up your thigh muscles. Imagine squeezing your thigh bones with your thigh muscles. Make sure this knee stays out. I know it's quite tough. And breathe in, press into your feet. Breathe out, sink a little bit deeper. One more breath. Keep squeezing that butt. Buns of steel. Inhale, come up. Back hand to back thigh. Turn the front hand palm up. Stretch up and back. So we're giving our legs a little bit of a rest. Either look up or look down to that back foot. If you can slide down a bit further than me, then go for it. Imagine you're trying to reach that back foot, but keep squeezing your tushy. Breathe in again. As you breathe out, come up and back into your warrior two. Then keep pressing that knee out. I want to really open up around the hips and groin. Lightly touch your elbow to your thigh. Get your right arm straight up, palm facing forwards. But try and draw your shoulder blade in towards your spine so you're not tensing your shoulders. Then keep pulling out the thigh muscles of this back leg. Check you're not resting on your elbow. So think of engaging your core. Inhale, press into both feet. Exhale, sink a little bit deeper. Really work those legs. We're not here for long. Ooh, I feel this tomorrow. Inhale, power up. Come all the way up. Turn the feet to face the front. And exhale, relax the arms. Bring your legs in. Give them a little bit of a shake. You may feel that tomorrow. I like it when I ache the next day because I know I've got my money's worth. Then keeping your feet underneath your hips, make sure you get a bit of space behind you. So make sure there's not a wall behind you. So when I turn, I'm going to stay facing you, then I'm going to turn because I've got a wall behind me. So you're going to take the weight onto your right foot, press down through your right foot, lengthen up through the crown of your head, and come into a tree pose. So you might rest your left foot toe on the floor. You might bring it to your calf muscle or hook your toes around the calf, or you might bring it all the way up onto your thigh. Just don't press on your knee joint. So anywhere other than on your knee joint. Firm up your belly slightly. Press through all four corners of that standing foot and lengthen the crown of the head up. Palms face forward. Reach the arms into a V for victory. So you're stretching to the corners of the room. Find a point to focus on. Absolutely anything. It's about eye level and something that's not moving. So you can keep your gaze steady and your breath steady. That's a trick to balancing, keeping your gaze and your breath steady. If you're, when your mind wanders, you tend to wobble. And if you do need to touch down, if you do need to use a wall, that's perfect. Just do what you can. Just keep lengthening up through the crown of the head, but relax the shoulders. Breathe deeply. Each time you breathe out, pull your belly button towards your spine. Again, challenge yourself. So it's quite tough, especially after the warrior work we just did. So challenge yourself and know that you're strong enough to overcome the challenge. Inhale, breathe in, breathe out, lift that knee up in front of you, like in a parallel tree position. Then squeeze in your tummy, and I'm going to turn sideways now because I haven't got enough room. But hopefully you will have done this where you have room behind you. Whoops, I need to touch down, that's okay. Breathe in again, bend your standing knee. As you breathe out, you're going to take the leg and your arms out behind you. You can keep that left leg bent, lift it up, try and come forward halfway. Squeeze in your belly button to your spine. Hold and breathe. So the standing knee is bent. Woo! Again, you might need to use the wall, and that's okay. Press into all four corners of that foot. See if you can lift that back leg a little bit higher. Squeeze your shoulder blades together. Breathe in. And breathe out. Slowly come back. And find your mountain pose. Awesome. Switching to the other side. So shift the weight. Find your tree pose, wherever that may be. And you may need to take a different variation on this side, and that's perfect. Press your foot against your thigh or your calf. And imagine pressing your calf back against your foot. Belly firm. Activate your standing foot. Then reaching the arms out to the corners, spreading your fingers out. Drawing your shoulder blades towards the back of your heart. And keep lengthening the crown of the head up as if you're trying to touch the ceiling with the crown of your head. Belly firm, gaze steady, breath steady. Pull up the thigh muscles of your standing leg. Smile. Breathe in. Breathe out. Release that leg. Bring it in front of you. Squeeze your tummy muscles. And giving, using your core to stabilize you. Breathe in again. As you breathe out, bend your standing knee. So you bring the arms, take the leg behind you. Try and keep it bent. And just tip forward as about halfway if you can. If not, don't worry. Lifting that leg up, reaching through your fingertips. Again, you may wobble. This is my not so good side. Keep sucking your belly button in towards your spine. Again, smile. Because it's not the end of the world if we do wobble. And breathe in again. And breathe out. Slowly come back to center. Fantastic. Bring your hands back to your heart. Close your eyes. Again, just check in. Simply noticing how you feel right now. And if there is one word to describe how you feel right now, and whatever word pops into your mind is perfect, there's no right or wrong answers. And even if you wobbled, I wobbled, that's okay. I always encourage students never to focus on the fact you wobbled or you had to put your foot down or you struggled. Focus on the fact that you gave it a go. Focus on the fact that you did it. Focus on the fact that it doesn't matter if your variation doesn't look like mine. Focus on the fact that you actually showed up for yourself by getting on the mat, because that is what it's important. And I say, we learn to balance by learning to wobble. And we get stronger actually by wobbling, because our muscles have to then kick in to try and keep us stable. So always, always leave your practice, whatever practice it is, with a feeling of accomplishment. Namaste. Enjoy the rest of your day. Beautiful soul. Make sure you go and drink lots of water. Have a rest if you have time. Lie down for 5-10 minutes. The exercises are still working in your body.